Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to interrupt a video with another or other media and then pick the video up right back where you left off. Hi and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 people that have subscribed, clicked on the little bell icon, and while you're at it, go ahead and share the video and leave me a comment as well. So this is a problem that someone brought up to me in the official ProPresenter users community that I have over on Facebook, and it didn't take me a long time to figure out a way to do this, but it occurred to me that there are occasions where maybe you've got a long video and you want to interrupt it and show something else and then go back to the video. So maybe that's a conference, maybe that is your pastor's out of town, something like that. Maybe you've got a pre-recorded video that you have worship up front, then you need to interrupt it with announcement time, when of course that's where you're going to be showing some slides, and then you need to go back to the video where you left off. So how can we do that in ProPresenter 7? Well, let's head over to my computer, of course, and take a look. So here we are in Pro 7, and so imagine that you've got a video. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click and I'm going to remove the Go to Next Timer on this. This is a slide loop, but you'll be able to see where I'm going with this. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click and change the behavior on this, because right now it's a background or foreground, and I want it to be a background. So, this is not even that. That is a playlist. So let's remove the playlist.
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
Okay. So, and I'm going to right-click and edit this slide because, yeah, just as I suspected, that video is actually on the slide layer. So, we don't want the main video to be on the slide layer. Now, let's see here. Let's right-click and, yep, now that's set to as a background. In this case, I do want it to stop and not loop. So I'm going to start this video. And then, so we'll start it, and notice how we've got this countdown going. Let's just hit pause right here. So there we go. We've paused it at 5 seconds and 29 frames. We still have 24 seconds and 1 frame. So the next thing that I want to do is show each of these slides for announcement time. So let me do that. If I click on it, notice that it covered up the previous video, and I can do this one is set to go because it's got the go to next timer, that, and then once the announcement time is done, it should go back here to this, and the problem is that it restarted. So again, how can we solve that? First off, I would make sure that I didn't have a looped beginning on this bottom one here. And what I'm going to do is add another slide. So let's doesn't matter which theme I choose, I'm just going to add one there. Okay. So this is paused. I go through each of these, right? And now when I get back to this last one, it's still paused, so I can just hit the play button and it'll pick up where it left off. So that's how I would set it up if I didn't have time to do it this other way that I'm about to show you. So that's kind of it's a really long video. I don't have time to preview it. We just need to go, and the pastor's told me to pause at a certain point. I'm just going to listen for that point and pause it live. That's how I would set it up. And by the way, these are all on the slides layer. So if I right click and I go into edit slide, you'll see that this is listed right here as on the slides layer. The reason that I could tell that earlier, because this has been a while since I set this up, is there's no icon up here. Unlike if I were to drag a video right there, notice that I have this icon. What I put up there was a background video. Same thing as here. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to remove that action so that it is only showing this on the slides layer. So that's an important piece of the puzzle too, is I need the first video to play as a background on the media layer, and then I need any other media that I want to play that needs to play on at least the slides layer. You could also put it on a prop, but I try and dissuade people from using props if they can avoid it, because props are so flexible that you might need them for something else that only they can do. So this would be a good way to do it, to put something on the slides layer quickly and easily if it's already down here in the media bin. You can just drag it up there, right click, and convert media action to slide element, and notice the icon went away, indicating that this is in fact on the slides layer. Now, I wish there was an easy way to move it back, but instead I'm just going to right click and edit the slide real quick, click on it and delete it, and then go back to show, and then I'm good to go. So, all that to say, that's the way if you don't have time to set this up ahead of time. But if you do have time to set this up ahead of time, let's right click on the first one and let's go to Inspector. And let's find a good ending point here. I'm going to say 4 seconds and 9 frames is a good ending point. So let's get out of the Inspector. And it should be that I play this until just comes to the stop, and it will dissolve at the end, because if we right click and again check on the inspector, where is it? Oh, right here. End behavior is set to fade to black. I could also set it to hold the last frame, and or black after the last frame, that'll just cut to black, or clear after the last frame, and that will basically dissolve it, or fade to black, which will dissolve to black, or fade to clear, remove it completely. So, could do that. Let me show you what it looks like when it holds at the last frame. See, it just basically pauses, and then I can go through these others that are again on the slides layer. And now I need this again, so I'm going to drag this up here again, and in this case they could be either foreground or background, doesn't matter all that much. I'm just going to right click and go into inspector, keeping in mind that this ended at 4 seconds and 30 frames. So go into inspector, and this one I'm going to start at 4 seconds and 30 frames. And that's probably close enough. I could also just let's see here. Oh, here we go. I could type that in right there. I thought you could type it in here, but I might be just misremembering. So do like that. Actually, let's back it up just a couple of frames just to be safe. And now I can, having been through all of these, I can click on that, and then it should just start basically where the other one left off. So that's the second way that I would do it. Is, so we've got basically 5 seconds here and 5 seconds and 7 frames here, so good thing. And then once this ends, I think that it is still set, yep, it's still set to stop, so it'll just stop. So those are the two ways that I would pause a video and pick up that same video afterwards. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.